Taking a quick look at line items, we can first off open this document and we see that line items were indeed captured. In order to capture line items, you have to go to your document definition and you need to click on document definition properties, and then you need to go to invoice settings, additional fields and features, and you need to make sure that line item extraction is checked, and it's not checked by default. So I'll just go ahead and close this up. And also, there is a database check rule, which I'll show you in a minute. That database check rule can help you ensure that the data on your form matches the data in the data set. So if we look at our data sets in the document definition, so we can again go to document definition properties, data sets, we actually have a line items data set, and we can view that data. And so this is the data that we're trying to match. And if we match that data, the fields will turn green. So let's see what that looks like. The way that we make those fields turn green is by doing a database lookup, which is configured here. And if we click on rules, there's a match invoice line items with order item. And it's essentially just a database lookup against a data set, our data set for purchase order line items. And we're just simply matching the unit price and the quantity and the total price. By default, it tries to match more. My recommendation is that you disable all but those three columns. So now that we've looked under the hood, let's take a look at what the batch shows us. So I'll just make a couple quick adjustments and we'll scroll down and take a look at our data form, and we can see that we've matched these three line items. We've got quantity, unit price, and total price in green. That means that we match the data on the data set. And if we click on this ellipses button, we can actually see the data that data was derived from, that it matched with. You can also describe which columns you want displayed. So if I right click here, this is a list of total amount of columns that you can choose from. And these are the columns that are turned on. So you can toggle these on and off as you wish. If something doesn't match a database lookup and you still want to mark it valid, you can just click that button. The is valid button will take care of that for you. If for some reason invoice line items have not been captured correctly automatically, you can do training here either at the operator level or at the administrator level. And that machine learning training could cause your results to improve. You can also alternatively capture your table data via an external flexi layout, an additional flexi layout at the vendor level.